يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. أما بعد. All praise is due to Allah. We seek His guidance. We praise Him as He should be praised. We seek His forgiveness. We seek His assistance. And we seek refuge in Allah from the evil within ourselves, from the evil of our actions. Whomsoever Allah guides, there is no one to lead astray. And whomsoever Allah sends astray, there is no one to guide him. I bear witness that there is no one worthy of worship except Allah, and I bear witness that Muhammad is his servant and his messenger. May the peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, upon his family, his companions, and all those who follow him until the last day. For you who believe, revere Allah as he should be revered, and do not die except in the state of Islam. Beloved brothers and sisters in Islam, over the past 24 hours, there have been a number of developments regarding the COVID-19 coronavirus. And a number of actions have been taken locally by our communities, the Muslim community, as well as the different authorities, in order to help protect ourselves and to preserve our communities. And last week, I had spoken here about the importance of taking the spiritual means. When we related to you the ahadith and the dua of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to say on a regular basis, أعوذ بكلمات الله التامة من شر ما خلق. I seek refuge in the perfect words of Allah from the evil that He has created. And then Bismillah الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم. In the name of Allah, in the one who by His name nothing is harmed in the heavens and the earth, and He is the all-hearing, all-knowing. And we emphasized the importance of taking these means, but at the same time, we also have to recognize that there are physical means that we do have to take. Over the next several weeks, the schools will not be in session. So the spring break has been extended for another 2 weeks. So that's 3 weeks in which our children will be remaining at home. And the purpose behind this is not to create a sense of panic. And we have to understand that. This is not about creating some sort of hysteria or a state of panic that where everyone then becomes seized up by fear and that they end up not doing anything other than just staying at home, locking their doors and not going out. That is not the point of this. But rather, the idea is to be able to take proactive measures, is to be able to help prevent the spread of this virus to the point where the health system, the hospitals, are no longer able to have the capacity to be able to deal with an increased number of cases. So it means that we have to do our part. We have to do our part when it comes to things as basic as personal hygiene, being able to wash our hands properly and often. Properly meaning that, you know, and there are a lot of different instructions out there, whether there are YouTube videos that have been put up by the World Health Organization or just locally by the London or the Ontario Health Authorities in terms of how to properly wash our hands. These are things that we need to become more aware of for the sake of our family and our children to be able to teach them these things. Okay, because our children might not necessarily know the reality that is before us. Right? And this is something that we do need to take seriously. People might say that, oh, this is just a big hype and that it's just, you know, that it's all hype. We take a balanced approach, that we don't dismiss it and say that there's nothing happening. Nor do we overemphasize the sense of fear that this is a pandemic, there's no question about it, and the World Health Organization has declared it as a pandemic. There's no question about it. But now, the idea is, how is it that we can contain so that we're not affected by it. First and foremost, we know, as was mentioned last week, قُلْ لَنْ يُصِيبَنَ اللَّهُ إِلَّا مَا كَتَبَ أَوْ لَنْ يُصِيبَنَ إِلَّا مَا كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَنَا قُلْ لَنْ يُصِيبَنَ إِلَّا مَا كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَنَا هُوَ مَوْلَانَا وَعَلَى اللَّهِ فَلْيَتَوَكَّلِ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. Allah tells us in the Quran, say, nothing will afflict us except that which Allah has decreed for us. It's part of the qadr of Allah. Nothing will affect us or afflict us except that which has been decreed by Allah. But then, Ruhul Mawlana, He is our protector. At the end of the day, everything is in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Absolutely everything. We take the means, but then we place our trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the message that we're given is that this is a reminder for us, now is the time where we turn back to our Lord. This is bringing to us that reality that exists. This is a place of tribulation. The dunya is a world of test. The dunya is a world of tribulation. And you're going to hear stories, and you may even experience things yourselves, within your families or your close ones or even yourself personally, right? This is a reality that it may come to pass within our lives in terms of, you know, people being affected by this disease, etc. For some it will be mild, for others it may be more severe. It's in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But then the question is, how do we respond to it? This is a time in which we need to turn ourselves back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have optimism. We have a good opinion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But at the same time, we take the right means and precautions, and we take it seriously. Because this is not something that we want to treat lightly. There have been a number of masajid in the community, that locally and across the GTA and in Ontario, and across the province and the country, that have taken these precautions, and they don't take these precautions lightly in terms of, for example, canceling all forms of gatherings. And again, this is part of as a precautionary note. Now, for these types of gatherings here that are small, that are 50 people or less, the risks are not as high as in places where the gatherings number in the hundreds. And just this morning, at 11 a.m., the Chief Medical Officer, Dr. David Williams, of the province of Ontario, issued saying that any group activities that consist of 250 or more people should be suspended. And any types of gatherings that are not necessary should also be suspended. So this is one of the reasons why some organizations here have canceled, for example, all different classes and halaqat over the weekend and during the week and programs and things like that, just out of, so that to help. For the five daily prayers, this is something that, you know, some masajid will continue to do just because they're not a large group of people. But when it comes to the larger gatherings like Jummah prayer, that they have said that they're going to do to suspend them indefinitely until over the next few weeks, until there are instructions that are given otherwise. Based on this, not only from a Shari'a perspective, this has a sound basis, and there have been many different fatwa that have been issued by qualified scholars, statements that have been issued by local council. The Canadian Council of Imams issued a statement yesterday that is a joint statement with the Muslim Medical Association of Canada. So they issued a joint statement to recommend not to have Jummah gatherings that would be in large numbers. And so that this was a recommendation. So for us, how does this impact us? How does this have an effect in terms of what the steps that we should take as individuals and for our families and as a community, is that we're vigilant. We continue to monitor the situation and we continue to abide by whatever recommendations have been put out by the relevant authorities, whether they're the health authorities or in terms of from within our Muslim community. Again, this is not about having a sense of fear or panic, but rather it's to help, you know, as they have been saying, flatten the curve. Because if there is an endemic or a pandemic in which the number of cases rises too quickly, right? Because this is something that is going to spread. There's no question about it. The health authorities have said it's not a matter of if, it's a matter of when. And so the point of these actions to be taken is to help mitigate the spread of this virus so that the number of cases are more spread out over a longer period of time rather than peaking in one point and then overloading the system. And then because of that, then more people end up becoming ill and end up dying from this type of virus. This is serious enough for us to be concerned as Muslims. And for that reason, a number of the masajid and the khatibs have even shortened their khutbahs for today, and for those that are holding them, and then for those that have canceled them altogether, they will do so indefinitely until the time comes in which we are instructed otherwise by the relevant authorities to do that. And so for this reason, I'm not going to take long in terms of the khutbah, but rather the last thing that I will say is we need to really focus on our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, have a good opinion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, have hope. This is a test. We are being tested as a community. We are being tested as individuals. And so we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us safety, to grant us protection, and that He grant us the wisdom to be able to make the proper decisions for ourselves, for our families, and for our communities in order to keep everyone safe. And this is by the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is what our Sharia teaches us, that it's about preserving ourselves in terms of our deen, in terms of our nafs, ourselves, in terms of our wealth, in terms of our intellect, and in terms of our lineage. These are the maqasid of the Sharia. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us protection and to grant us help during this challenging time. وَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ وَإِنْ لِكُمْ سَبْسِنِسْ مِنُمْ كُرِذَمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُ إِنْهُ وَقُولُ الحمد لله رب العالمين أفضل الصلاة والسلام على سيدنا النبي المرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات المسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك يا ربنا سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين اللهم ارحمنا وتعالى وموت المسلمين واشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين واحفظ المسلمين في مشارق الأرض وفي مغاربها وارفع البلاء والكرب والظلم والفتن والقتل والمرض عن أمة نبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وانصر بنا وبجميع المسلمين بلطفك فيما جرت به المقادير ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار والحمد لله رب العالمين